In this lesson, we will talk about the Revolve tool. There are objects and shapes that are symmetrical, which means they are made up of exactly the same parts facing each other or rotated around an axis. This axis is called axis of symmetry. With the Revolve tool, you can rotate an open or closed profile around its axis of symmetry to create a surface or solid object. As you can see in the drawing area, a chest pawn and a bottle have been created. Those objects were created by revolving a profile around an axis. As you can see, both profiles and axis of symmetry have been created, so I can show you how the Revolve tool works. The Revolve tool can be found in the modeling panel of the home ribbon if I click on the arrow below the extrude tool. Alternatively, I can type Revolve in the command line and press Enter to activate it. Once the tool is active, the message Select Object to Revolve appears. So I will select the pawn's profile and press Enter. Then I have to specify the axis of revolution, so I will click on the end point of the axis and then I will click on the other end point of the axis. Finally, I need to specify the angle of revolution. Since I want to achieve a full revolution, I will type 360 and press Enter. In this way, the profile is rotated 360 degrees around the axis. Notice how easily and quickly I created the solid object with the Revolve tool. Now I will create the bottle, so I will activate the Revolve tool again, and this time I will select the bottle's profile. Once I select it and press Enter, I need to specify the axis of revolution. Instead of specifying the endpoints of the axis, I can select the object option that appears in the command line. Now a message prompts me to select an entire object as the axis of revolution. So I will select the line. Finally, I need to specify the angle of revolution. In this example, I will type 180 and press Enter. Notice that I created a bottle cut in half. Let's move on now to some other examples in order to show you the rest of the options for specifying the axis of revolution. I will activate the Revolve tool again, select the profile of the bottle, and press Enter. When it's time to specify the axis of revolution, I will select the Y option and notice that the profile revolves around the Y axis. At last, I will specify the angle of revolution as 360 and press Enter. Notice that the profile revolved 360 degrees around the Y axis, creating a full bottle. In the next example, I will revolve the profile around the X axis. To do that, I will activate the Revolve tool again, select the bottle profile, and press Enter. Now I have to specify the axis of revolution, so I will select the X option and notice that the profile indeed revolves around the X axis. At last, I need to specify the angle of revolution. I can select the reverse option to change the direction of revolution. This works similarly to enter a minus angle value. Notice that now the profile revolves in the opposite direction. This time I will type 90 and press Enter. The profile revolved 90 degrees around the x-axis, creating a quarter of the bottle. At this point, I will activate the Revolve tool one last time to show you the revolution around the z-axis. I will select the profile of the bottle again and press Enter. Then, from the axis of revolution options, I will select the Z option and, as expected, the profile revolves around the Z axis. As for the revolution angle, this time I will select the Start Angle option. With this option, I can specify an offset for the revolution from the plane of the object being revolved. Simply put, I can define where the revolution will begin. To get a better picture of what that means, I will type 200 and press Enter to specify the start angle. Then I will type 180 and press Enter to create half of the bottle. Notice the final result.